Good evening friends, I am Pradeep Kumar here. In this example, this is lecture number 3, Wired Networks in NS2. Please go through this full video. You will get various aspects and concepts about wired networks in networks related to. So most of the students and researchers, what do they do is, when they start their work in NS2, they immediately wanted to develop a code rather than worrying about the design. So this session I am going to tell you about how to design a network rather than coding a network. So first part, I will design a network. In the second part, I will be coding this network. See, for example, first I am using a concept called as wired network. How I am going to design? So this is my network. So I am going to design 6 nodes. So what do I do here is, node number 1, node number 2, node number 3, node number 4, node number 5 and node number 6. So you can able to see there are totally 6 nodes I have given. So I will name it 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So totally 0 to 5, totally I have created 6 nodes. So now what I do is, since it is a wired network, so all these nodes will have a wired connectivity. So I will just join it according here. So for variation, I will just showing the color here. So I want to make the variation like this. So from 0 to 1 there is a node, from 1 to 4 there is a node, from 3 to 4 there is a link, and from 4 to 5 there is a link, and from 1 to 2 there is a link. So most of these links are, so we call it as duplex link. So duplex means both side transmission will be possible. So when the node 1 can be send the packets to node 2, same time node 2 also can able to send the packets to 1. So most of this network, in the wired network, since there is a line involved here, we need to have only 2 parameters. One is the bandwidth, another is the data rate. So bandwidth decides how much amount of data I want to send it to the link, and data rate decides in what speed the data will be sent. So high bandwidth, small data rate indicates that it is a very fastest link. So I just, since it is a design of a network, what do I do is, I design between each line all the link could not they may not be having the common bandwidth or common link. So as for example, if this node could be in one of a local area network, it's go to the gateway. So from local area network to the gateway, I will be having one bandwidth and one delay. So this could be the bandwidth to the ISP, so in the internet service provider. So there could be the national backbone. So each link will be having a different bandwidth and different data rate. So in this case, what I am going to do is, I am going to fix the data rate. So for understanding, what I do is 5 Mbps, 2 milliseconds. So in this link, I have created 5 Mbps and 2 milliseconds. Here I want to give 10 Mbps and 5 milliseconds. So in this, from 1 to 2, I want to create a speed of 10 Mbps and 5 milliseconds. This I want to give it as 3 and 10. So I have given these two metrics here. 3 is 3 Mbps bandwidth and 10 millisecond is the. And here I want to give 100 Mbps, 2 milliseconds. 100, 2. So here I am giving 100, 2 milliseconds. And finally, I want to give 4 Mbps. And 10 milliseconds, 4 Mbps and 10 milliseconds. Now I have created a node, I have created the link, I have created the bandwidth and the delay between each and every link. Now what I do is, I need to decide the source and the destination. For better understanding, what I do is, I make S1 as source 1, S2 as source 2. So S1, S2, source 1, source 2. Destination, I use D1 here as destination. And 5, I use T2 here as destination 2. So for example, the source 1 wanted to send a packet to D1 and S2 wanted to send a packet to D2. So S1 to D1 and S2 to D2. Okay. Now I want to send a packet from S1 to D1 and S2 to D2. So this packet will go via this way and this packet will go via this way. So from 0 to 1, it will be at a bandwidth delay of 2 millisecond delay will be there. The bandwidth will be around 5 Mbps speed. And from 1 to 4, it will be 3 Mbps bandwidth and 10 millisecond delay. From 4 to 3, it will be 100 Mbps bandwidth and 2 millisecond delay. So this will be the fastest link available. You can see in the network animation window also. So once this is designed, I need to send how the node source, the source node will send a packet to the destination. Okay. In this case, what I do is we call it as agents. We call it as agents. So source is the node which generates packets and it creates agent. So we'll be calling it as agent. Similarly, here also I'll be having an agent. Destination will be having agent unless destination sends a packet. If a destination sends a packet, it will have an agent. If it does not send any reverse packet, it doesn't have any agent. But in NS2, since we are dealing this network design in NS2 have this kind of agent. Those who doesn't send any packets, we call the agent as null agents. Okay. Now in this case, what I do is let me the node number 0 use the packet UDP. It sends the packet UDP, whereas node 2 wanted to send TCP. Node 2 send TCP. So source nodes is there. So UDP and node 3 is the destination. So here what I do is I have a agent called as, I want to fix it here. Similarly, I have a agent here, I want to fix it here. I'll tell you what kind of agent they will be having. So UDP, the packet will come from 0 to 1, 1 to 4 and 4 to 3, and this is a destination. So UDP user datagram protocol, which doesn't have any acknowledgements. So that is one thing everyone knows. But other thing in about UDP is, if the same source node, there are 2-3 packets will be generating from the same source node and they go via. All the packet they doesn't know they are siblings. So they do not know they are from the same source. So that's how the UDP doesn't have any session maintenance. So once it reaches there, I want to give it as null agent. So UDP 0 to null. So in this case, what happens is the null agent doesn't reply any packet here because UDP doesn't bother to receive the acknowledgement. So it will be called. So here as TCP here needs an acknowledgement. So it's a reliable transmission protocol. It needs an acknowledgement. So I make this agent as sync. We call it as TCP sync. So this agent will be sync agent. Okay. Now node is there. It has an agent. What these agents carry? We know it is packets. What kind of packets it will carry? So that's what decided here. So that packet is nothing but I use CBR. The value is CBR, whereas TCP it uses FTP. CBR and FTP. So CBR is nothing but constant bit rate. Maybe I'll write it here. Constant bit rate. So constant bit rate is one of a keyword you would have heard about in many places. So let me say a good example is the MP3 files. So MP3 files, what happens is I can download from internet like 192 kbps, 320 kbps. So far these two are common, but earlier we were having 128 kbps. So what here happens is 128 kbps files will be having very lesser in size, but the quality also will be nominal enough. But 192 will be good enough and 320 kbps will be very, very good quality. Also the size occupied by this will be very good quality. Please remember that 320 kbps per second means this is a constant bit rate. Right through the song, when you listen to the song, this speed will be maintained. So that's what UDP will do. Similarly, audio, video signals, all these signals are sent via UDP only because of this constant bit rate. So these CBR packets have been taken by the agent UDP and carry over to the network. FTP, you are downloading a file from internet, for example. Let's say you are downloading an operating system or an ISO file or something you are downloading. So when you download the file transfer protocol, it's a trivial protocol. What it do is, this file will not be constant always. So you can see, the file transfer protocol, what happens is, the file transfer could not be always be constant. So sometime you can see file manager, it will be showing like this. So that means the speed could not be constant always. The FTP, the speed could not be constant always. So this is, we call it as variable bitrate. So this bitrate is not constant, it is variable. So sometimes you have a good bandwidth, it will be very fast enough. In the same bandwidth, for unwanted reason, it will be very slow enough because the speed will be decided by the server or by the receiver or the sender. So because of these reasons, this will be having a variable bitrate. So CBR is being generated at this node number 0, which will be carried by the UDP agent and goes via 0143. So in this packet it will come like this, 0143. This will be coming like this, whereas this packet will be moving like this, 2 1 4 and 5. This is how it moves. Okay, so having said that, I have designed the network now. So I have a complete perfect design of my network now. Now we will see so many metrics about this network. Please remember, when you know how to design a network, your coding is very simple enough. So CBR packet is been generated, which will be carried by the UDP, goes via 0, 1, 4 and 3. Null agent. The null agent doesn't reverse any packet, so the no packet will be returned from this null to UDP, whereas TCP, FTP packet is generated, which will be carried by TCP, goes via 2, 1, 4, 5, whereas the sync agent will be sending a packet back. Please see that they do not have any packets attached to it because they are on the receiver side. They will be only receiving whatever the sender is giving. So maybe the same example we can give it for so many examples, for congestion control, for flow control, for error control, and how TCP behaves in heavy traffic volumes. And we can change this value, instead of 3,10, we can change it to high bandwidth like 100,2 or 100,5, like this. So we can able to see what happens to this link, because this is a very important link, because an UDP also going via this link and TCP also going via this link. Other these links have doesn't have any relation because they are not having any context. So this will be having a thing and this will be having, so only this link will be one of the toughest link that we can see in the simulation. So over to the simulation now. The same example, I'll take a screenshot and then explain case to case then and there itself. Thank you. Stay tuned for the coding.